اطلب العلم أخي فهو درب به نور، به ترقى به تحيا عالما حرا فخور.
اطلب العلم أخي فهو درب به نور، به ترقى به تحيا عالما حرا فخور.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله وكفى، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على عباده الذين اصطفى. وبعد، we will be continuing with the story of the Prophet Moses, may peace be upon him, and what happened after Fir'aun was drowned and they were now on the other side of the Red Sea.
Moments after Allah saving them, they walked. Just moments. They just finished. They just saw something that many people in this world have not seen. And then they go past a tribe of people. What does that tribe do?
وجاوزنا ببني إسرائيل البحر فأتوا على قوم يعكفون على أصنام لهم.
As Banu Israel crossed, they came across some people who were worshipping some idols.
قالوا يا موسى اجعل لنا إلها كما لهم آلهة.
They said, O Musa, we would like you to appoint for us some idols just like they have idols, so we can worship a few of these.
Subhanallah, you want an idol to worship like these people? You want to worship an idol beside Allah, the one that just saved you right now? Did you just forget what you just saw? You just finished from a great miracle. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made you see where not many people see. And now you are willing to replace Allah with an idol that you make with your own hands?
قَالَ إِنَّكُمْ قَوْمٌ تَجْهَلُونَ.
He said, you are people who are completely ignorant.
إِنَّ هَؤُلَاءِ مُتَبَّرٌ مَا هُمْ فِيهِ وَبَاطِلٌ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ.
All these people, what they are in is completely wrong. It is utterly useless. It is a means of their destruction.
Obviously, these people need shelter. They need water. They need food. Where are they going to get it from the desert? There's nothing in the desert. There's only dust.
وَإِذِ اسْتَسْقَى مُوسَى لِقَوْمِهِ فَقُلْنَا اضْرِبْ بِعَصَاكَ الْحَجَرُ.
When Musa alayhi salam asked us to quench the thirst on behalf of his people, he asked a question. We want something to drink. Allah says, we ordered him to use the same stick and to hit the rock. When he beat the rock, Allah says,
فَانْفَجَرَتْ مِنْهُ اثْنَتَا عَشْرَةَ عَيْنًا قَدْ عَلِمَ كُلُّ أُنَاسٍ مَشْرَبَهُمْ.
12 different springs gushed out of that huge rock. And because they were members of the families of 12 of the children of Jacob, they were part of 12 different families, 12 different lineages. Each one knew exactly which spring belonged to their particular group, and they all drank from their particular spring. And as they went further, they felt hungry. And it was a desert. It was bare land. So they asked Allah for shade. And they asked Musa alayhi salam for food.
وَظَلَّلْنَا عَلَيْكُمُ الْغَمَامَ وَأَنزَلْنَا عَلَيْكُمُ الْمَنَّ وَالسَّلْوَى كُلُوا مِن طَيِّبَاتِ مَا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ.
Allah says, we caused a cloud to be a barrier between them and the sun. Allah says, for you, O Banu Israel, we even used the clouds to shade you. And on top of that, we released for you from us the divine food known as al-man was salwa. Man is a type of grain, and salwa is a type of a bird. Some say it is a quail. So Allah says, we gave that to you. Allah says, eat and thank Allah, be grateful, and protect yourself from mischief making.
وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَى لِقَوْمِهِ يَا قَوْمِ اذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ إِذْ جَعَلَ فِيكُمْ أَنْبِيَاءَ وَجَعَلَكُمْ مُلُوكًا وَآتَاكُمْ مَا لَمْ يُؤْتِ أَحَدًا مِنَ الْعَالَمِينَ.
When Musa told his people, all my people, remember Allah's gift upon you, when he made from among you prophets and kings, and he had given you what he had given no one else in this world. what Allah had granted you, He did not grant anyone. So thank Allah in return.
So he says, now Allah has issued an instruction for us.
يَا قَوْمِ دُخُلُوا الْأَرْضَ الْمُقَدَّسَةَ الَّتِي كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ وَلَا تَرْتَدُّوا عَلَىٰ أَدْبَارِكُمْ فَتَنْقَلِبُوا خَاسِرِينَ.
O my people, enter the blessed land of Jerusalem. We are going to go there and we will be victorious over the people that are there. Do not go back because then you will be losers.
إِنَّ فِيهَا قَوْمًا جَبَّارِينَ.
In that particular town that you want us to enter, the city of Jerusalem, there are people who are tyrants. How do you expect us to go into there?
وَإِنَّا لَن نَدْخُلَهَا حَتَّى يَخْرُجُوا مِنْهَا.
We're not going to go in there until those people come out of that place.
Subhanallah, what kind of people are you? Allah's telling you to go in. And Allah Azza wa Jalla is ordering you to fight. And not only that, but Allah guarantees you victory. They said, no, we're not going to go in until the people walk out. Subhanallah, what kind of people are you? What kind of a nation are you? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is promising you victory. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is promising you that once you walk in, Allah will give you victory over these people, although that you are weaker than them, although that you're not as prepared as them. But because of Allah's victory, Allah will give you victory. Because of Allah's powers and strength, Allah will give you victory over these people. Just walk in and Allah Azza wa Jal will give you victory over these people, and then you could take over that land. They said, no, we're not going to get anywhere. Two men spoke out from Bani Israel. Just walk into their gates and you see Allah's victory coming down. Just walk in. Maybe you don't even need to fight. Just all you have to do is march in and you see Allah's victory coming down on your hands. Just walk in, do nothing. What more do you want? A victory, an opening without you doing nothing except to walk. So what did they respond back and say?
إِنَّا لَن نَدْخُلَهَا أَبَدًا مَا دَامُوا فِيهَا.
They said, no ways, we are never going to go in there.
فَاذْهَبْ أَنْتَ وَرَبُّكَ فَقَاتِلَا إِنَّا هَاهُنَا قَاعِدُونَ.
Go, you and your Lord fight, we are sitting over here. With full disrespect, not only to Musa alayhi salam, but to the Lord of Musa Rabbil Alameen. Go, you and your Lord, we are sitting over here. Yeah, fight. When you finish, call us, we'll come in.
قَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي لَا أَمْلِكُ إِلَّا نَفْسِي وَأَخِي فَافْرُقْ بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَ الْقَوْمِ الْفَاسِقِينَ.
Musa alayhi salam made a dua. He said, Ya Allah, you've issued me an instruction here. I only have command over myself and my brother Harun. The rest, I don't have a command over them. Look at what they are saying. So separate between us.
إنها محرمة عليهم أربعين سنة.
It will be prohibited for them for 40 years to have any form of dwelling. They won't go into the city and they won't go anywhere for 40 years.
يتيهون في الأرض فلا تأس على القوم الفاسقين.
They will just be wandering on the earth. So do not be saddened by the condition of the mischief makers. So from that day, for 40 years, these people used to get up in the morning and try to go and look for an abode. And they would come back in the evening exactly where they started.
Someone will say, oh no, there's a city here or there's a town there. They'll walk and walk and can't find it. Allah Azza wa Jalla always misguides them.
They started becoming unruly and they started doing as they please. So Musa alayhi salatu wa salam made a dua to Allah, Ya Allah, I would like some laws, some regulations, something that we can govern these people with, something that they can follow in order that they may succeed. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَوَاعَدْنَا مُوسَى ثَلَاثِينَ لَيْلَةً وَأَتْمَمْنَاهَا بِعَشْرٍ فَتَمَّ مِيقَاتُ رَبِّهِ أَرْبَعِينَ لَيْلَةً.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instructed Musa alayhi salam to fast for 30 days in seclusion. And for some reason, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala later decided to add another 10 days.
وَقَالَ مُوسَى لِأَخِيهِ هَارُونَ اخْلُفْنِي فِي قَوْمِي وَأَصْلِحْ وَلَا تَتَّبِعْ سَبِيلَ الْمُفْسِدِينَ.
He says, oh Harun, I want you to take care of these people in my absence, and I want you to do good, and I want you never to follow the path of the mischief makers.
And Musa alayhi salam, he promised Bani Israel that he'll be back after 30 days. So Musa alayhi salam, He rushed in his travel until Musa alayhi salam arrived to the place in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had promised him to be in.
ولما جاء موسى لميقاتنا وكلمه ربه قال رب أرني أنظر إليك.
موسى عليه السلام went to Allah. He spoke to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the same spot where Allah had met him first, and he says, Ya Allah, I'd like to ask you something. I want to see you, Ya Allah. I've heard you, I'm speaking to you, but I want to see you, Ya Allah.
لن تراني.
You will never see me. Not here, not with these eyes, not in this world, no.
ولكن انظر إلى الجبل فإن استقر مكانه فسوف تراني.
But look at that mount. If it remains in its place, that means you will be able to see me.
فلما تجلى ربه للجبل جعله دكا وخر موسى صعقا.
Allah says, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala released some of the nur onto that particular mount, it was destroyed to pieces. And Musa alayhi salam fell unconscious. And after some time, he got up, he regained consciousness. Allah says,
فَلَمَّا أَفَاقَ قَالَ سُبْحَانَكَ تُبْتُ إِلَيْكَ وَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ.
When he regained his consciousness, he said, Glory be to you. I seek forgiveness for having asked what I just asked. He says, I am the first from the believers.
When Musa alayhi salam was there for 30 days, Musa alayhi salam is worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah azza wa jal will speak to Musa constantly. And Musa will speak to Allah azza wa jal constantly. During those 30 days, Musa alayhi salam was fasting every day. And because of his fasting, the breath of Musa alayhi salam started to change. Because of that, Musa stopped fasting. So Allah azza wa jal told Musa, why did you stop fasting? He said, Oh Allah, my breath was changing. So I stopped fasting, so my breath has a good fragrance. And this is something that you might be pleased with. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Musa, Oh Musa, don't you know that the changing breath of the one who fasts is more beloved to me than the fragrance of musk? And because of that, O Musa, you've done something they should have not done. Because of that, you stay an extra 10 days. So from 30 days now, became 40 days. After 30 days, Bani Israel are waiting for Musa to come back. Where is Musa? Ya Harun, where is Musa? Allahu alam, he was supposed to come in 30 days. 31 days went past. Few days went past after 30. Where is Musa? Musa promised us that he's coming back. It looks like Musa is lost. And all the rumors started to take place. And Bani Israel could not relax and be stabled. And Harun alayhi salam was the soft type of person. Relax, Bani Israel. Musa will come back. Relax, Bani Israel. Musa will come back. When Bani Israel left Egypt, many of the masters that they used to work for, they left a lot of their jewelry with them. When Bani Israel left Egypt, they took some of those jewelries that belonged to their masters.
There was a man known as Samiri. He told everyone that I seen the angel when he was leaving. Some dust fell off the hoof of the horse he was on, and I gathered that dust. And he says, I'm going to mix it now. Bring all the jewels, all the jewelry you people have collected from the people of Fir'aun. It is dirty. You can't use it. Bring it. We're going to throw it in this fire. So he made a big fire, and they started throwing all the jewelry in the fire, and it was melting. As it's melting, he decided, I want to mold a god for you people. So he made from the gold and the silver and everything a calf. The calf was hollow. Why hollow? Because they didn't have enough to make the cow full from inside. And as the wind blew, it was making a sound.
And then Samiri started to call out and say, this is the Lord that Musa is looking for, and that's why Musa is late.
وَاتَّخَذَ قَوْمُ مُوسَى مِنْ بَعْدِهِ مِنْ حُلِيِّهِمْ عِجْلًا جَسَدًا لَهُ خُوَارٌ.
Allah says, when Musa alayhi salam went, his people started worshipping the calf because it was making a noise. When the wind blew, because it was hollow, it made a sound. Ooh, the little sound. When they heard the sound, they said, this is a god. It's got a life in it. It's got a life in it. Look, how can you debate? How can you argue? Come see that life. Listen to the sound. You think jewelry can make a sound? This is only a god, that's why. And they started worshipping it.
Harun saw that scene and was so amazed. Oh, Bani Israel, what's wrong with you?
You replace Allah Azza wa Jal with something that you make with your own hands?
They told him, لَن نَبْرَحَ عَلَيْهِ عَاكِفِينَ حَتَّى يَرْجِعَ إِلَيْنَا مُوسَى.
We will continue worshipping it until Musa comes back to us. Who are you to tell us?
Majority of Bani Israel
prostrated and submitted to that golden calf, except a small number. The scholars say they do not exceed 70. Out of 600,000 Ikhwani, only 70 did not worship that calf. And the rest all thought to worship that calf. Then Musa alayhi salam, he'll continue his worship until the 40th day.
So Allah tells him, قَالَ يَا مُوسَىٰ إِنِّي اصْطَفَيْتُكَ عَلَى النَّاسِ بِرِسَالَاتِي وَبِكَلَامِي فَخُذْ مَا آتَيْتُكَ وَكُمْ مِنَ الشَّاكِرِينَ.
O Musa, I have chosen you over and above all these people for two things. The first is that I have spoken to you and I have given you a message. So two things that happened to you that didn't happen to those around you. I have chosen you for in order to give you this wahi. So take this book. Take what we are giving you and be from amongst those who are thankful. So Allah says that the people that you have left behind, there is a man known as Samiri who has already begun to lead them astray. So anyway, when Musa alayhi salam got his alwah, his tablets, and it was already written, he picked them up from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he went away.
Now Musa alayhi salam coming back from 40 spiritual days with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He heard from Allah, he spoke to Allah, Allah addressed him every single day. Musa alayhi salam just came back from a high spiritual training camp with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for 40 days. To be shocked and surprised that within 40 days, the people of Bani Israel replaced their Lord Allah with a golden calf made with the hands prostrating to it. When Musa saw that, he got so angry.
He put the tablets down and he grabbed hold of his brother, shaking him.
Ya Harunu, ma mana'aka idh ra'aytahum dallu alla tattabi'an afa'asayta amri.
What's wrong with you? When you saw them going astray, why didn't you follow what I told you and sort it out? Stop them from doing it. Why did you go against my instruction?
He says, Ya bana umma, la ta'khudh bi lihyati wa la bi ra'si.
Oh my brother, don't hold my beard and my head.
Inni khashitu an taqula farraqta bayna bani Israel wa lam tarqub qawli.
I had a different fear. My fear was that if I had been hard on them, I may have split the community into two and you would have then come and say, Ya Harun, why did you split Banu Israel? You should have waited for me. So he says, it was more important according to me to hold them together knowing that you're coming back with instruction. And Harun alayhi salatu wasalam tried his best, but they didn't listen to him. So he left it at that and he told Musa alayhi salam, at least now they are in one piece, you can deal with them. So Musa alayhi salam asked the question straight to Samiri.
Ma khatmuka ya Samiri?
What's your problem, O Samiri? What is it that you did?
Basurtu bima lam yabsuru bih.
I saw something that no one else saw.
Faqabadtu qabdatan min athari ar-rasul.
So I got one handful of the dust from the hoof of that horse of the messenger of the angel.
فَقَبَضْتُ قَبَضَةً مِّنْ أَثَرِ الرَّسُولِ فَنَبَذْتُهَا وَكَذَلِكَ سَوَّلَتْ لِي نَفْسِي.
So my own mind and my own soul, my desire told me that this is what I should do. I must put it into the fire together with all this, and I should make something, and that would be a god, because the source of part of it was from the hoof of that particular horse that the angel came on. Now what he saw and what not, all that, he probably was hallucinating. قَالَ فَذْهَبْ فَإِنَّ لَكَ فِي الْحَيَاةِ أَن تَقُولَ لَا مِسَاسِ. He said, go. For you, from now on, for the rest of your life, you will only be able to utter one word, and that is La Misas, which means don't touch me.
Allah Azza wa Jal send on that man a disease. If anything touches him, he goes crazy. He screams from pain and torture. So he can't go near anything, not anything can go near him. And he was left alone.
Anyone who came near him, he could only say, don't touch me, don't touch me, don't touch me, throughout the rest of his life. وَإِنَّ لَكَ مَوْعِدًا لَن تُخْلَفَهُ. And you have an appointed time and place that will never ever miss you, and you should know Allah will get hold of you for having encouraged and engaged in this. And still when I'm asking you, you're proud to tell me what you did. No repentance, no nothing. So Allah says, Musa alayhi salam told him, وَانْظُرْ إِلَىٰ إِلَٰهِكَ الَّذِي ظَلْتَ عَلَيْهِ عَاكِفًا لَنُحَرِّقَنَّهُ ثُمَّ لَنَنْسِفَنَّهُ فِي الْيَمِّ نَسْفًا. Look at this God that you were worshipping. We will burn it, we will melt it completely and throw it into the water.
And he grabbed that golden calf and he destroyed it and demolished it. And after he destroyed and demolished it, he threw it in the sea. Can't see what your Lord can do now if you claim that this is your Lord. When Bani Israel saw that their own Lord can't even save himself, how was he going to save them? If their own Lord can't even protect itself, how was he going to protect them? So they all start to feel guilty and remorse. And they came to Musa apologizing and they wanted to repent. But the repentance was very, very tough. Allah Azza wa Jal sent his anger and wrath on the people of Israel. Because such an action, not only they worshipped the calf, but they worshipped it after what Allah had shown them with their own eyes, after what they've experienced. And now you replace Allah with such thing? If you really want to repent to Allah, well, Allah Azza wa Jal has shown you the path of repentance. You know what was the repentance to Bani Israel because of the action they did? Whoever wants to repent to Allah must go and kill himself. If you want Allah Azza wa Jal to forgive you, if you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept your repentance, then go and slaughter yourself. So many of them did, and a lot more didn't. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran Kareem that He accepted the repentance of those who did repent to Allah Azza wa Jal.
And then Musa alayhi salam looks at all the people and says, إِنَّمَا إِلَهُكُمُ اللَّهُ الَّذِي لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ وَسِعَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ عِلْمًا. Your Rabb is the one, Allah, no one worthy of worship besides your Maker. You never worship anything besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He has the knowledge of absolutely everything.
He told them, O Bani Israel, I came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with His commandments, and here are the tablets that Allah Azza wa Jal had ordained His orders in. Take it and follow what's in it. So they said, oh Musa, yes, this is from your Lord, these are the orders, but we're not just going to take it like that. We will look into it. Whatever we like, we will take. Whatever we don't like, we're going to reject. This is something that we want to decide on. Allahu Akbar! Musa alayhi salam was amazed. What's wrong with you people? Is this your response to your Lord, the one that saved you? Is this the response to what you've seen and what Allah Azza wa Jal made you see? Take what Allah Azza wa Jal had ordered you. He's Allah's orders. He's Allah's commandments. Take it. And they said, no, we're not going to take. We will look into it. Whatever we like, we'll take. Whatever we don't like, we'll reject. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Musa alayhi salam, tell them to take it by force. Allah is not telling you now to take it by option. Allah is telling you to take it by force, whether you like it or not.
You're going to take it by force and remember what's in it. Act upon it. So they said, no, we're not going to take it. We will look into it. We'll discuss it between us. We'll see whatever we like, we'll take. And whatever we don't like, we'll reject. Subhanallah.
Allah grabbed one of the mountains nearby and He put that mountain at the top of their heads.
And then the mountain spoke. Allah says,
when we made the mountain speak above their heads like a shade, saying, take what Allah had ordered you by force
and remember what's in it. Act upon what's in it. So what did they do then? They went and prostrated to the ground and they said, yes, we'll take what's in it. When they prostrated, they had one side of their faces on the ground, the other side looking at the mountain. When they took the tablet from Musa alayhi salam, Musa was so upset, so sad from the action of his people. Musa wants good for them. He wants to save them from Allah's punishment. He wants his people to be the best of people. But his people are acting. They're acting wrong.
After that, they told Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, ya Musa, we want to speak to Allah. You are speaking to Him. We want to come and listen. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, still He permitted that. So Musa alayhi salam was told, select 70 wise men from amongst your people and bring them. وَاخْتَارَ مُوسَى قَوْمَهُ سَبْعِينَ رَجُلًا لِمِيقَاتِنَا. Musa alayhi salam chose 70 people to come to the appointed place where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had instructed them to come.
Musa alayhi salam, he said, stand here. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to address me.
And Allah Azza wa Jal is going to give you the honor today
that you will hear Allah Azza wa Jal addressing me. While the 70 are standing, Musa is there at the front. A cloud will come and cover on all of them that they can't see each other. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will address Musa alayhi salam. Those 70 are listening to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to Musa alayhi salam. And then, after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ended, the cloud went away and they were there just looking at Musa. This is not enough for us. You want us really to believe in you? You really want us to be a follower of you? You really want us to be strong with you? Let us see you, Lord.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent a lightning and a thunder together with a jolt, a tremor, and they all died.
Ya Rab, I came with 70. I came with them alive. I'm going to go back dead with them. Oh, what bad Israel think of me, Ya Rab al-Alameen? So he said, Ya Rab, if you want to destroy them and me from before or now, this is up to you, Allah. Ya Allah, you destroy us because of the wrongdoing people from among us. This is your test. You will guide whoever you want, Ya Allah, and you will misguide whoever you want. Ya Allah, Ya our close Lord that we worship, and Allah, forgive us and have mercy on us. And you are the best of forgivers. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted what Musa asked for.
ثُمَّ بَعَثْنَاكُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَوْتِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ.
We gave them life after they were dead so that they can be thankful.
He brought one alive after the other. So the one that comes alive, he sees the dead one come back alive. So they could see it with their own eyes. And they could go back and say, we were dead. And Allah brought us back alive. And I saw this dead person on the ground and Allah brought him back alive. But this, my brothers and sisters, did not increase their iman. They were the worst of people.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that we instructed them from the commandments that on the Sabbath they were not allowed to work at all. وَلَقَدْ عَلِمْتُمُ الَّذِينَ اَعْتَدَوْا مِنْكُمْ فِي السَّبْتِ. You know the people who broke that covenant regarding the Sabbath, and they hatched their own plan thinking they would make a fool of us. إِذْ تَأْتِيهِمْ حِيتَانُهُمْ يَوْمَ سَبْتِهِمْ شُرَّعًا وَيَوْمَ لَا يَسْبِتُونَ لَا تَأْتِيهِمْ كَذَلِكَ. These people on the Sabbath, the fishermen, they used to notice the fish are all coming. And when it was the Sunday, the fish all went away. So Friday, no fish. Saturday, like the fish knew that, you know what, today we're not going to be fished. So let's all go and tease these people. So they came, and when the fish were teasing, these people worked a plan. They wanted to find a loophole around the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what did they do? They came on Friday evening and cast all their nets. Sunday morning they picked them up with all the fish. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, as a punishment, قُلْنَا لَهُمْ كُونُوا قِرَدَةً خَاسِئِينَ. We converted them into apes because they transgressed. Allahu Akbar. After that, they became tired of this man and salwa, because for 40 years they had to be in the desert. وَإِذْ قُلْتُمْ يَا مُوسَى لَن نَصْبِرَ عَلَىٰ طَعَامٍ وَاحِدٍ. Oh Musa, how long are we going to be patient eating the same food every day? How can we eat the same food here? We want you to call out to Allah. فَدْعُ لَنَا رَبَّكْ يُخْرِجْ لَنَا مِمَّا تُوبِتُ الْأَرْضُ مِنْ بَقْلِهَا وَقِثَّائِهَا وَفُومِهَا وَعَدَسِهَا وَبَصَلِهَا. They said, oh Musa, we want our herbs again, we want our cucumbers again, we want our garlics again, we want our lentils again, and we want our onions again. We want everything we used to have, bring them back, and we want it to grow. Tell Allah we want that. So Musa alayhi salam looks at them and he says, أَتَسْتَبْدِلُونَ الَّذِي هُوَ أَدْنَى بِالَّذِي هُوَ خَيْرٍ. You want to substitute the good that you have with that which is not as grand. How can you want to take away the divine food that Allah blessed you with and substitute it with something you used to know in Egypt? So he says, if you are really asking for that, there is a possibility that Allah will return you to Egypt in a condition that you will once again have all of that, and together with it, you'll be oppressed again.
And 40 years, they were nagging on Musa alayhi salam. Look what your Lord did to us. Look what you got us into. We were more comfortable at the time of Fir'aun. We were more comfortable to be slaves. We were more comfortable at that time.
Thereafter, that there was another way that they harassed Musa alayhi salatu was salam. They troubled him a lot. They started spreading a rumor that this man has a disease, a skin disease or some form of a disease they spoke about. That this man, you know, beneath his clothing, he's got a very big sickness. And they accused him of something very dirty, very rude. A sickness with the reproductive system. So the rumor began to spread amongst the people. Now there was no ways of clarifying it. That's why they started saying this man is sick. How are you going to clarify it? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided to clear it for Musa.
يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ آذَوْا مُوسَى فَبَرَّأَهُ اللَّهُ مِمَّا قَالُوا.
O you who believe, do not be like those who harmed Musa alayhi salam with the accusation. So Allah had to clarify him and free him from that particular accusation. So what happened? As he was having a bath one day behind a rock, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused that rock to run away with his clothing. So Musa alayhi salam is running behind a rock. And as he's running, a few men who were there, they happened to see him. And they said, this man is perfect. Everyone is saying he's sick. He's not sick at all. So now it was cleared. And he got hold of the rock, took his clothing and quickly wore it. But in the interim, Allah had saved him. Thereafter, there was a man, a very, very wealthy man. He passed away. And he left one son. And this one son, he inherited everything. So the cousins were quite jealous and they murdered him. When they murdered him, there was a problem. There was a debate. Who murdered this man?
So one of them said, why should you bother? Why should you bother going through all these hardships into looking who killed him? When you have a prophet that he claims he speaks to his Lord, just go and ask him. So they went to Musa alayhi salam and they told him, oh Musa, you're a prophet, you're a messenger. You say you speak to Allah and you say you speak to the Lord of this universe. Then show us some of your miracles. And one of those miracles that we really want to see today, tell your Lord and ask him who killed our leader.
So Musa alayhi salam made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and one day he comes back
وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَى لِقَوْمِهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُكُمْ أَن تَذْبَحُوا بَقَرَةً.
Musa alayhi salam came back to his people and he says, oh my people, Allah has solved your problem. He wants you to sacrifice a cow.
So what did Bani Israel respond back to Musa? You making fun of us? What's this got to do with slaughtering a cow? We're telling you one of our leaders got killed and assassinated, and you're telling us go and slaughter a cow? You making fun of us or something? A'udhu billah. Now ask Allah to protect me from being from the ignorant ones. So they said, okay, it looks like you're serious.
قالوا ادع لنا ربك يبين لنا ما هي.
Make dua to Allah to inform us a little bit more detail. What type of a cow does he want?
So Musa said, Allah said slaughter a cow. So just go and slaughter any cow. From the cows, there's many of them here in front of you. Go and slaughter any. They said, no, that doesn't make sense. You know, you're talking about something serious. They have to be more serious. And Musa said, just go and slaughter any cow. There's no need for you to make it hard on yourself. So they said, no, it doesn't make sense to us. So Musa alayhi salam went to Allah and he said, oh Allah, what kind of a cow is it? So they became hard and Allah became harder on them.
قَالَ إِنَّهُ يَقُولُ إِنَّهَا بَقَرَةٌ لَا فَارِضٌ وَلَا بِكْرٌ عَوَانٌ بَيْنَ ذَلِكَ فَافْعَلُوا مَا تُؤْمَرُونَ.
A cow, neither too old nor is it too young, something in between. And do what you've been ordered, follow the instruction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and your issue will be made easy.
So they said, okay, this is not enough of a description. We've got a lot of cows are like this. We've got a lot of cows at average age.
قَالُوا دَعُوا لَنَا رَبَّكَ يُبَيِّن لَنَا مَا لَوْنُهَا.
O Musa alayhi salam, make dua, call out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let him tell us, what's the color of the cow?
Musa said, any color, just go and slaughter it. They said, no, that's not enough. So they became hard again, so Allah Azza wa Jalla became more hard on them.
قال إنه يقول إنها بقرة صفراء فاقع لونها تسر الناظرين.
A yellowish cow, so yellow that it's not mixed with no other color, that it attracts the sight of people when they see it.
They started looking, they found quite a few. So they went to Musa alayhi salam, ya Musa, we've got a problem.
قَالُوا دُعُ لَنَا رَبَّكَ يُبَيِّن لَنَا مَا هِيَ إِنَّ الْبَقَرَ تَشَابَهَ عَلَيْنَا وَإِنَّا إِن شَاءَ اللَّهُ لَمُهْتَدُونَ.
O Musa, we are confused. There's too many of these. And we don't know, they're all quite similar. So you tell us, ask Allah to give us a little bit more detail. And inshallah, we will be guided.
And Musa said, just go and slaughter it. Why are you making it hard on yourself? Allah's making it easy on you. Make it easy on yourself. Don't make it hard, or else Allah will make it hard on you. So they became hard again, so Allah Azza wa Jalla became more hard on them.
قال إنه يقول إنها بقرة لا ذلول تثير الأرض ولا تسقي الحرث مسلمة لا شية فيها.
Allah says, it must be a cow that was neither prepared to till the land nor prepared to be used for irrigation. It must be perfect without a spot on it. Now it became very hard. They started hunting for the cow. They told Musa alayhi salam,
الآن جئت بالحق.
Now you've come with something that is understandable. So they went around, they started hunting for the cow. They found one cow belonging to someone. So they went to him and they told the young man, we want to buy this cow. It fitted everything that Musa alayhi salam was told. So he said, look, I can't sell it. I need to speak to my mother. He went to the mother. They were talking about a price and they were speaking. And then the mother said, look, how can you sell it? We don't want to sell it at all. Until the boy says, okay, finally, I'll settle for the skin of this cow filled with gold.
فَذَبَحُوهَا وَمَا كَادُوا يَفْعَلُونَ وَإِذْ قَتَلْتُمْ نَفْسًا فَادَّارَأْتُمْ فِيهَا وَاللَّهُ مُخْرِجٌ مَا كُنْتُمْ تَكْتُمُونَ فَقُلْنَا اضْرِبُوهُ بِبَعْضِهَا كَذَلِكَ يُحْيِي اللَّهُ الْمَوْتَى وَيُرِيكُمْ آيَاتِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَعْقِلُونَ.
They slaughtered it, and remember when the person was murdered, and you were debating and arguing as to who murdered that particular person, we instructed you to take a chunk of the meat from this cow and strike with it the dead man, and when he was struck, he came up alive after he had died. And he said the name of the person who murdered him, and he died again. This is how Allah gives life to the dead. Allah says, we've done it so many times in the past.
ثُمَّ قَسَتْ قُلُوبُكُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ ذَٰلِكَ فَهِيَ كَالْحِجَارَةِ أَوْ أَشَدُّ قَسْوَةً.
Then your hearts became hardened after that, so they became as hard as rock, and even harder than rock. Musa alayhi salam was asked a question by someone. Ya Musa, we want to know who is the most knowledgeable person.
So Musa alayhi salam, as a prophet, as a messenger, from his knowledge, from his experience, from looking around, he thought there is no one more knowledgeable than him. So he said, me. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to teach his servant and slave and messenger a good lesson. Don't say something that you don't know. And he told him, oh Musa, who told you you are the most knowledgeable person on earth? So Musa alayhi salam, with full humbleness, he said, ya Allah, I did not think of anyone being more knowledgeable than me.
Ya Musa, nobody can know everything there is to know in knowledge, but we send down knowledge in pockets, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses some with more than one, but not everything. So Allah wanted to show Musa alayhi salam, there is a certain pocket of knowledge which we have granted someone besides you. Musa alayhi salam was interested to know, who is this?
You will meet him where the two rivers meet. When you lose your lunch, that's where you will meet him.
So Musa alayhi salam was instructed to take his lunch and to go on a certain path on the coast. Now the lunch was made up of some items in a basket, and it had in it a little fish. It was a fish that was not dead. It was in the water, in a little container.
وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَى لِفَتَاهُ لَا أَبْرَحُ حَتَّى أَبْلُغَ مَجْمَعَ الْبَحْرَيْنِ أَوْ أَمْضِيَ حُقُوبًا.
When Musa alayhi salam told his servant, I would not stop and give up until I get to that place where the two rivers end.
فَلَمَّا بَلَغَ مَجْمَعَ بَيْنِهِمَا نَسِيَا حُوتَهُمَا فَاتَّخَذَ سَبِيلَهُ فِي الْبَحْرِ سَرَبًا.
When they got to where the two rivers end, Musa alayhi salam was so exhausted. So he went and sat under a tree and slept. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the sign. They had in their little basket fish to eat.
The fish suddenly got out and got into the sea, and it was gone. But Musa alayhi salam was asleep. So he said, I'll wait for Musa alayhi salam to get up and then I will tell him. But when Musa alayhi salam got up, he forgot. And he took the basket and he carried on walking.
فَلَمَّا جَاوَزَا قَالَ لِفَتَاهُ آتِنَا غَدَاءَنَا لَقَدْ لَقِينَا مِن سَفَرِنَا هَذَا نَصَبًا.
After a while he got tired. He says to his young man, he says, you know what? Give us our lunch. Now we're very tired on this road. We've gone a long, long, long way.
قَالَ أَرَأَيْتَ إِذْ أَوَيْنَا إِلَى الصَّخْرَةِ فَإِنِّي نَسِيتُ الْحُوتِ وَمَا أَنْسَانِيهُ إِلَّا الشَّيْطَانُ أَنْ أَذْكُرَهُ وَاتَّخَذَ سَبِيلَهُ فِي الْبَحْرِ عَجَبًا.
Remember when we sat down and you relaxed and you slept?
The fish found its way into the sea in a most amazing, astonishing manner. And I forgot to tell you. And it is only Shaytan who made me forget.
ذَلِكَ مَا كُنَّا نَبْغُ.
This is exactly what I've been waiting for. This is the sign that Allah had given me. Once I lose my food, that's where I'll find that man.
فَارْتَدَّا عَلَىٰ آثَارِهِمَا قَصَصًا.
So they went back following their footsteps to the exact place where this fish had gone.
فَوَجَدَا عَبْدًا مِّنْ عِبَادِنَا آتَيْنَاهُ رَحْمَةً مِّنْ عِنْدِنَا وَعَلَّمْنَاهُ مِنْ لَدُنَّا عِلْمًا.
They found a worshipper of ours whom we had blessed from blessings from us, and whom we had granted knowledge directly from us.
Musa alayhi salam knew that's a man. And who's that righteous servant? It's Khidr alayhi salam. Some say he's a wali, others say he's a prophet. But he was someone that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave knowledge.
He was from the ummah of Musa alayhi salam. He was following the sharia of Musa alayhi salam. But Allah had given him some knowledge. Some knowledge that was not given to Musa alayhi salam. And this was just a point that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was proving to Musa alayhi salam.
قال له موسى هل أتبعك
موسى عليه السلام says may I please be in your company
على أن تعلمني مما علمت رشدا
so that I can learn a little bit of this wisdom and guidance that Allah has given you.
قال إنك لن تستطيع معي صبرا
he says oh Musa you are not going to be able to bear patience with me.
وكيف تصبر على ما لم تحط به خبرا
How are you going to be patient regarding that which you have no knowledge about?
قال ستجدني إن شاء الله صابرا ولا أعصي لك أمرا
He says, Inshallah, you will find me to be patient. I won't question and you will find me not going against any of your instructions.
So Khidr alayhi salam, he put the conditions. If you follow me, you don't ask me about anything until I tell you. Okay? So Musa alayhi salam, they said, yes, agreed. And now the test begins. They went on their journey. They wanted to go from one part of the sea to the other side. So they saw a small boat with poor, weak people working on the boat. So they told them in a nice way, can you please be generous to us to take us from this side to the other side? So those weak, poor people said, no problems, come on board. So Musa alayhi salam and the Khidr went on that boat.
And as they jumped into the boat, the first thing they saw is a little bird. A bird sitting on the plank. And it dipped its beak into the water. It says once or twice, it dipped its beak. And Al-Khidr tells Musa alayhi salam, Ya Musa, did you see this? He says, yes, I saw it. Did you see the amount of water being displaced when the beak of the bird went into the ocean? He says, yes, I saw it. He says, the comparison of the knowledge of Allah with that we have is similar to one little droplet and the whole ocean which Allah has. So Allah's knowledge is like the whole ocean and we only have a little droplet. Whatever was displaced by that beak going in and coming out, that's all.
He, Musa alayhi salam, is thinking, Wallah, these people are very good people. They were so generous and kind of us to let us on board and take us from this side to the other side. He turns around. Where's the Khidr? He goes and looks for the Khidr. The Khidr is trying to break the boat. Subhanallah, we're just thinking about how good these people are, how generous they are, and you are breaking their boat.
حتى إذا ركب في السفينة خرقها قال أخرقتها لتغرق أهلها
موسى عليه السلام said you want to drown these people here so he says
قال ألم أقل إنك لن تستطيع معي صبرا
didn't I tell you you will have no patience with me
قال لا تؤاخذني بما نسيت
he says hey sorry I forgot
ولا ترهقني من أمري عسرا
Musa alayhi salam is apologizing. He says, I'm really sorry. It was just forgetfulness and now I won't ask you anything. So they carried on.
حَتَّى إِذَا لَقِيَا غُلَامًا
فَقَتَلَهُ When they arrived to the other side of the sea, they were walking. They saw a group of kids playing. Al-Khidr, he saw one of the kids. He grabbed him on the side. He put him on the ground and he killed him. Allahu Akbar! Musa, a prophet, a messenger, is seeing a murder. Seeing such a crime happening in front of him. He was shocked. And who? What? A little kid.
He says,
أَقَتَلْتَ نَفْسًا زَكِيَّةً بِغَيْرِ نَفْسٍ
So Musa alayhi salam said, you just killed an innocent life. How could you do something like this? This is haram.
He says,
قَالَ أَلَمْ أَقُلْ لَكَ إِنَّكَ لَنْ تَسْتَطِيعَ مَعِيَ صَبْرًا
Didn't I tell you, you will not be able to bear patience, ya Musa? So he says, okay.
إِن سَأَلْتُكَ عَن شَيْءٍ بَعْدَهَا فَلَا تُصَاحِبْنِي قَدْ بَلَغْتَ مِن لَدُنِّي عُذْرًا
Musa alayhi salam says, now if I question anything, you don't have to have me in your company. It's okay. This is the last. So they started walking.
They arrived to this town, tired, hungry, thirsty. They asked them for the smallest of hospitality. They refused. One by one, give us water, no. Food, get out of here. Bread, not interested.
فوجدا فيها جدارا يريد أن ينقض فأقامه قال لو شئت لاتخذت عليه أجرا.
They saw a wall when they were leaving that was almost falling. So Al-Khidr stops for a while and made an effort to straighten the wall and solidify it, make it strong, and then he walked away. So Musa alayhi salam says, these people refused to even any form of hospitality. No food, no accommodation, nothing. If you wanted, we could have told him, we'll fix your wall, pay us. Why did you fix a wall without any recompense? So Al-Khidr says, هذا فراق بيني وبينك. Thank you very much. It's now enough. This is the splitting between me and you. You go your way and I go my way.
You promised me once, you broke it. Twice, you broke it. The third time, you told me, if you break this promise again and you're going to ask me for something before I tell you, everyone goes their way.
سأنبئك بتأويل ما لم تستطع عليه صبرا.
I'm going to explain to you now what I did. The first thing.
أما السفينة فكانت لمساكين يعملون في البحر فأردت أن أعيبها وكان وراءهم ملك يأخذ كل سفينة غصبا.
Remember the boat that we broke it. It belonged to people in need. And those poor people were generous and kind enough to allow us to come on board and take us from one place to another. And you saw me in return, what did I do? I broke a part of it. To you, you see that from your outside knowledge, you see that as a crime. But if you know the reality of what I did, I done them the biggest favor. There was a king, a tyrant king. He was looking for every good ship around. And if he saw that ship with no fault in it, he would have took it. So I made that fault in that corner. So when the king sees that, he'll let that ship get away. And yes, after Musa and Khidr went on land, the king came and took all the ships except that ship. Why? Because it had that broken part that Khidr alayhi salam did. So what did Khidr do here? He done them a favor.
Subhanallah. Point number one. Musa alayhi salam did not know. The next one. He says,
وَأَمَّا الْغُلَامُ فَكَانَ أَبَوَاهُ مُؤْمِنَيْنِ فَخَشِينَا أَنْ يُرْهِقَهُمَا طُغْيَانًا وَكُفْرًا فَأَرَدْنَا أَنْ يُبْدِلَهُمَا رَبُّهُمَا خَيْرًا مِّنْهُ زَكَاةً وَأَقْرَبَ رُحْمًا.
And about that kid that we slaughtered, his parents are good people. From Allah's knowledge, this child is going to grow up. He was going to grow up to be an evil child. And he's going to cause so much hardship. We wanted Allah to exchange him with a better child, a child that's been granted rahmah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and righteousness. The moment that this kid was slaughtered and killed, Allah azza wa jal made his mother fall pregnant. And Allah azza wa jal gave him a righteous child.
The third one.
وَأَمَّا الْجِدَارُ فَكَانَ لِغُلَامَيْنِ يَتِيمَيْنِ فِي الْمَدِينَةِ وَكَانَ تَحْتَهُ كَنْزٌ لَهُمَا وَكَانَ أَبُوهُمَا صَالِحًا فأراد ربك أن يبلغا أشدهما ويستخرجا كنزهما رحمة من ربك وما فعلته عن أمري.
And about that wall. That wall that belonged to that house belonged to two young orphans. And under that wall, there was a big treasure hidden by their father. To them, their father was a righteous man. And you saw Musa with your own eyes, the people in that city and town are so wicked, so evil that a cup of water wouldn't even give us. So could you imagine if that wall falls down and they're still young, what would the people of that village would do? They'll take their treasure. So we renovated it enough and long enough for that wall to stay up until the kids grow up. When they grow up, they're strong enough that when the wall falls, they take their treasure, no one else.
You see, I did not do this out of my own. Each item I was instructed. Why did he say that? Because according to the Sharia of Musa alayhi salam, he would have been penalized for murder.
ذَلِكَ تَأْوِيلُ مَا لَمْ تَسْطِعْ عَلَيْهِ صَبْرًا.
That is the explanation of what you could not bear patience regarding. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam says, we hope that Musa alayhi salam would have had more patience so we could have learned a bit more from that Al-Khidr.
Musa alayhi salam stayed suffering with Bani Israel until the last moment of his life. 2 years before his death, Harun alayhi salam passed away, his brother. There's some narrations that say Bani Israel accused Musa for killing his brother. That's how stubborn they were.
And then 2 years later,
the angel of death was sent to take the soul of Musa alayhi salam. He asked him for the permission. Musa slapped him.
So the angel of death went back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he says, Ya Allah, you have sent me to take the life away from someone who doesn't want to go. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, go back and tell him that, O Musa, you will have as much life as when you put your hand on the back of an ox, the number of hairs that are under your hand. For each hair, we give you 1 year. Is that okay? So the angel of death went back and tells Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, Allah says, you put your hand on the back of an ox, how many hairs come under that hand of yours? For every hair you have 1 year. Is it okay? So Musa alayhi salam says, and then what will happen? He says, and then death will come. He says, in that case, I'd rather go now.
But before that, he said, Ya Allah, allow me to be buried where you throw one stone away from Bayt al-Maqdis, Jerusalem. And he took his soul. So Musa alayhi salam is buried, maybe now in Jerusalem, because Jerusalem expanded.
When Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went through what is known as Al-Isra, from Makkah al-Mukarramah, right through to Bayt al-Maqdis, he says, I came across the grave of my brother Musa alayhi salatu wa sallam, under a red hill on the side of the road. If you take me there, I will show it to you now. And he says, I went through. Musa alayhi salatu wa sallam was engaging in salah. Now one might ask, why did Musa alayhi salam want to prolong his life? What was the reason? Very simple. He really wanted to see the victory of Jerusalem. So he wanted to prolong his life so that he could enter that territory that was promised to him by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But when he realized that this is the decree of Allah, he said, we don't want to contest it until we meet again. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad. Subhanallahi bihamdihi, subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.